Hey, what's up guys, Brad here. So today, as the title says, we're taking a look at Orcus in Duel Links. They're a very, very good engine in the TCG. They've been meta for about a year and a half now. So in Duel Links, can they be that good? And what we're doing is we're pairing it with Desperado Barrow Dragon, one of Duel Links' most infamous meta decks, just based on the fact that it is down to sheer luck. So we're going to dive into some duels. Again, there'll be the usual deck discussion and also some replays afterwards. But speaking of Desperado, are you Desperado for a brand new game to play? Then why not try out the sponsor of today's video, Raid Shadow Legends. If you haven't heard of Raid before, though I'm sure you have, it's a dark fantasy themed RPG game available on mobile and now also on PC. It's free to play and the best part is it's cross-device, so you can start your Raid experience on your mobile when on the go, then take your progress to the big screen on PC for when you're at home and want some insane looking graphics with your turn-based combat. The summonable champion roster is diverse with some crazy character models, my favourites being the archers, especially Elaine, who shoots bolts of lightning from her arrows. And with both PvP available from the arena as well as PvE events in campaign and dungeon runs, there's a lot of gameplay here. And if you don't like a champion you've pulled, well, you can sacrifice them to power up the ones you do want to invest into, which I think is pretty neat. And if you want to help me out in events such as the clan boss, then you can find me in game under the name It's Brad as HD. Thank God that wasn't taken. What I really like though is how it reminds me of classic old school RPG games with turn-based combat and a lot of hidden depth when you really want it, as well as the daily rewards from both quests and playtime rewards which keep me coming back for more, especially knowing the fact that I'm being rewarded for my time invested in game, something that the new Battle Pass feature does just right. Season 1 is now live, and without spending a single penny, you can start obtaining rewards such as gems, summoning shards, and even new artifact sets for your characters, and champions to upgrade and improve your arsenal of heroes. So, if you want to check out the game for yourself, go to the links in the description down below, and if you're a new player, you can get 100k silver and a free champion, Hexweaver, who looks really cool to be honest. You can find your rewards here in your inbox for the next 30 days only, so be sure to be quick. Once again, thank you to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring this video. And now, onto the PvP duels. Orcus are really cool because they can special things out from the deck, from the hand, from the graveyard, you can get things back from the banished pile, you can get a draw too, you can just do a lot. And honestly, Heavy Starter is actually, this is actually a wild hand because we know she's using, she's using good old Light Swans, Artnia Blair. So we're going to start with our boy Harp Horror, which if you play the TCG, you know Harp Horror is banned, which is interesting. We got him in Duel Links. Obviously right now he's pretty good, but the deck isn't as explosive as it is in the TCG, obviously. Now, in a few weeks time, we're getting Rex with Black Salvo, a card that when it's normal summon, you can get things out from the graveyard, then go for a synchro. He is going to make Orcus really, really cool. So I'm looking forward to playing this now and then coming back to it in a couple of weeks and playing with Black Salvo and seeing just how good it can be, because I'm excited. But this Blair is running Light Swans with Outstanding Dogmarin. I do want to play Light Swans at some point on the channel. Hopefully that might be the next video, because we did spend a lot of money to try and build the deck, so we might as well try and play it. Now, this deck just does a lot, doesn't it? I didn't even see what she got rid of. So she has Wolf, Lumina, Ryko, Raiden. So she does have four. She does have four units in there, and she now has a level 7 on the field, so she can go for a Michael. She can do all the things with popping our guy, banishing it, which I really don't want her to do because it does banish, doesn't it? It does banish it. Which you really don't want. Because it does then just kind of shut down this deck. Now, if she doesn't play JD. Didn't play JD. She milled JD. Didn't play him though. So now we can actually, hopefully, assume this thing doesn't get, please don't get floodgated. It's not going to, okay. So we can blow up our Blast Spine and blow up a Michael. Which is going to hopefully trigger and hopefully work. World Legacy Clash, no. No. But we do still get him a Desperado. Which means we do get a nice little attack to the face. We are also going to set return. Because yes, I know that Judgment Dragon seems to be coming next, or coming soon in this duel, but Bless put herself in a bit of predicament because she can no longer pay 1,000 to blow up a board. So she has to get JD out and manually crash into him, which then prompts the battle phase, which means we can then pop it. So she's really got herself in a bit of a pickle. So honestly, I would have let Michael die and then get the JD, but I don't think she even has JD. I think her JD is in the graveyard. Both of them are in the graveyard now. Two Wizard JD in the graveyard. There's a Blast Spider. That's going to be game, I'm afraid. Because we're just going to be able to pop itself and then pop, you know, the Michael. So Blast Spider, pop him and pop our Michael. And that should give us Desperado's effect off. Michael's, of course, is going to then regain life points. Oh, I forgot about that bit. Okay. That's worrying. Because now it just depends on what she can get back. But if she's going to put every light swarm back into the thing, then she's going to grab quite a few life points. We're also going to get Desperado out as well. Though we might be fine, that's 24, which she might not have enough to gain back. Plus 24, that's 20, 26. Now, hopefully, we can kill this thing here. Ah, it's a Raikou, no! Oh, no! It's a Raikou, Ah, no! She sent another JD to the graveyard. So now all of her JDs in the graveyard, but she can easily get to Michael. Again, if she has another one, which is, you know, or Black Rose, which is a pain. That's really annoying. But she only has two light swarms in the graveyard, so right now I think we might be in a good spot. Did we misplay that? Oh, there's Lila, so she can target to destroy our face down, which is an alternate return, which we don't really need, which is whatever. Where's Michael again? So, pay 1,000 to banish a card on the field. When its card is destroyed, you can target a number of other monsters in the graveyard, shuffle into the deck. Yeah, so either way, the same thing would have happened. Because we can't pop face downs with a Desperado. So, I feel like the exact same would have happened. Now, here we can risk it. Because what's in the graveyard is both of them, again, I think. No, just so that's going to give us, if we just get rid of the Lila, that's giving us, that's putting four in his graveyard, he can't get out anyway. So we're going to risk it and see if we can pop two. There we go. Cool. Nice. So we can get these into the graveyard. Now, if she does end up summoning two monsters to go into a synchro, we have Treacherous Face Down, which is going to, you know, help us out immensely. We're so close, and I know we haven't really seen the whole Orcus thing yet. It's been a bit of a disappointment in that regard. There is the Lila. Again, coming out. Which means that she can't have that much of a play. And we don't want to blow up both, you know, we don't want to do that. We just want to wait and see, because any of the Orcusts can really help us. Any of them. You want to give me any of them and they can help. Symbol Skeleton can help. Yes. That will do it. So we can almost summon our Skeleton. Now, again, it's a case of, do you go for the try and pop more than one and get nothing, or do you go for the guaranteed attack? I just want to see her graveyard, because this is really the thing, right? So what do we have in here? We have two Lumina. So there's one left in the deck, assuming you're playing three. So that's a very high chance of drawing into that. Getting back, please pop one. One pops two. Okay, we can do some guaranteed damage, which is great. So we can go blow up Lila and blow up Wolf again, and then get some damage in with our Symbol Skeleton, which is not what you want to use it for. You know, you can use him, you can use the Brass Bombard to go for a Synchro Summon. You can do a ton with this deck, and just getting Desperado out is one way you have of guaranteeing some damage and some destruction. As I said, the Orcus deck is kind of like an engine. Getting the Raiden, which is interesting that you would do that, Blair. Because that face down can't be anything important. So we can pop you. And we technically can pop Simple Skeleton. We don't need to, because she's going to completely rage quit and surrender, which is what we wanted. Now, let's go in for one more duel, because that did take a very long time. And we do have some duel replays and deck discussions and stuff afterward as well, so we do have all of that. But I want to get to the Orcus stuff. I want you to see the Orcus stuff actually work, because the replays do show Orcus kind of working, getting out some synchros and stuff, and doing some nice tribute summons. And you can also brick quite hard, because we are running heavy starter, which can give you hands of all level 10 or level 8s or whatever, you know, so it can be a mixed bag. We're going up against an Ishizu, so most likely going to be a Steel Tombs player, Dark Magician maybe, or is it going to be another Lightsworn? It's going to be another Lightsworn. Okay, so we just had a bit of a very close matchup with a Shiranui player. That was actually a really fun match. That took like 12 minutes, honestly, for a duel. So obviously we lost, which is disappointing, but we're going to go in for one more, see who we can come up against. Hopefully it's not that Shiranui guy again, although I would like the chance to destroy him again. But in that duel, we showed off a bit more of how the Orcus interaction kind of works. But Roy EA, you have Weavile as your icon. I'm really not hoping for a lot. Alexis Rose, could this be Gishki or Necroz or something of the sort? Winner will gain a rank. That's always nice to see. Heavy starter, we can give us. You can give us. Not a bad hand. That's not a bad hand at all. Because Simple Skeleton, we can send it to the graveyard. That can then, I think Skeleton's the one that summons from the hand. It is. So, oh no, Cyber Angels. What are you doing? Oh god. This is going to be a fun time. This will be a fun time of just sitting back, taking our time, chilling with some interactions and seeing what happens. Into Izana turn one. Obviously, she does have some protection in the graveyard. This all depends on how far she can go. There's Petite Angel. How far can you... Yeah, you don't really do much. That's what I'm... Ooh, another Simple Skeleton. Okay. So, right now, we're actually like... We could have done with any of the other ones. I would have been good. Okay. Okay. We can't use you, because it summons out one from the graveyard, which means everything I was just saying was a complete lie. And also the fact that in the graveyard right now, she does have Angel Ritual, which protects, which is not very fun. So, honestly, I want to get something in the graveyard first. Hopefully we can survive this turn from a complete onslaught from new Cyber Angels. Does she have piercing? I don't think she does, but she can attack monsters twice. So, ideally, okay, she has the Petite Angel. That's going to give her access to a lot of things, which means I feel like what's coming now is the Dakini. Going to send it to the graveyard, then just wipe me out. Adding Machine Angel Ritual. Wait, Nani? I'm lost, unless like it was a 2 and so was Petite Angel, but I'm really confused right now. However, she's really just, I don't know, she's got 3 whole protections in the graveyard, which is kind of interesting by itself. So we can now actually do some really cool things. So first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to activate the effect of Heart Horror, which is going to let us bring Heart Power of our Simple Skeleton, going to let us bring back Heart Power to the field. That by itself is pretty cool. Then we're going to activate Orchestrated Return. That's going to let us discard our Simple Skeletons, draw 2. We kind of wanted to see this card be discarded, but sure, that's whatever. So now we can either go for the Jinzo and you know, forgetting trap effects, which is whatever, we don't really want that. Or we could do the Blast Spider, which we're going to target Harp Horror, we're going to target the Benten, because that's going to get protected by you. However, our guy is still going to be destroyed. We're going to get our Barrel Dragon out to get you out into the field and attack mode. We're then going to use Harp Horror's effect in the graveyard. That's going to allow us to grab access to our Brass Bombard. And now we have Synchro Place opened up for us, which right now is only Samsara. Which Samsara is actually going to be very useful right now, because with that Cyber Angel with Zarya in the graveyard, we can potentially go into that if it gets destroyed. And also now we have a orchestrated Brass Bombard in the graveyard, which can then summon out an Orcus from our hand next turn. We're going to just straight up attack in, which might be the wrong idea. However, just getting some guaranteed damage on her right now is by far the best thing we can do. We don't really care about baiting out that Machine Energy Ritual in the graveyard, because we know we can bait it out in the battle phase the next turn. So right now, it's not that important. And even if Desperado dies, we have access to our Samsara, which can bring it back. So now, betting it all on Absolute Ritual, which by itself doesn't do much exactly. So there you go, you scoop it up, and there you go. Cyber Angels defeated our nice person, wasn't really playing the most optimal build. But you know what? We'll do one more, because that duel was fairly quick in comparison, and I do kind of want to play a little bit more Vorkas, because they are a very, very fun deck to play around with when you start getting your pops off and your special summons. So you can kind of see where you go. When you're locked into the darks, you kind of go for your Samsara. When you're not, and you just summon out your Brass Bombard normally or whatever, you go into your Armades or your Crystron, and then you can start doing some manipulation of the field and just ignoring the back row. So there's a ton of cool things with this deck that will only get better over time, which is why I really like it. So heavy starter once again against Lumis and Umbra. Okay, this is not the best, because Symbol Skeleton does stuff in the graveyard, so we'll just set it. But you know what, opening up a Desperado Barrel Dragon is honestly, a Desperado Barrel Dragon and level 4 is the best play you can get, or like just the bare minimum best play you can get, because the monster will be flipped up, be destroyed, you then summon a Desperado. However, do not want to see Red Eyes Fusion, because I'm pretty sure Desperado Barrel Dragon does indeed target. Or doesn't it? It doesn't look like it does, which, that'll be interesting, because it doesn't say it targets, it just says destroy. But, we're going to have to wait and see what happens here. Slash Dragon attacking in to our face down, which of course, oh, Diddy Boy, that's not very nice. Summoning out the Desperado Barrel Dragon, we're gonna see what happens here. I have a feeling that it's gonna get negated and destroyed, but we'll have to wait and see. Hitting the 2, only going to destroy you. Yep, blow you up. Nothing happens there, that's good. Orchestrated Return as well, that coming clutch, there we go. So we'll discard our World Wand, and then draw 2. There's a negation face down as well. I assume that's to trigger a skill. Light and Dark, probably. that's probably what you're going to use for that one. We did open up to our Brass Bombard, which actually is... that's actually very nice right now. However... because we can technically make, we can make Vermillion, which we could then target to, you know, get rid of the back, to get rid of, not the back row, to get rid of that. But we will right now go for our Cosmic Cyclone, of course, trusty card, get rid of that face down. What is it going to be? Spirit, do it. Bring him back. Bring back Red Eyes, I dare you. Fiendish Chain. Okay, this guy got lucky on the selection box, I see, but doesn't matter. We're good. See, now here's a toughie. It's how do we get around this thing? Like, I feel like you summon Blast Spider. Obviously, you can't do that. So it's like, oh, let's just attack him with this. It's going to be a DD Warrior, and it's going to get popped at something. It's a DD Warrior Lady. Oh, no. No. However, we can activate the effect of our Desperado and try and get a pop off. We can get a pop off, which is very nice. We can pop you. That's fine. Activate Blast Spider, just do a little bit more damage. And of course, you're going to scoop it up because that's what you do when you're faced with a Desperado Bower Dragon. So let's go and take a look at the deck and see just how does Orcust run as an engine right now in Duel Links. We've got a good mix of gameplays in this video, so we should be fine, but let's take a look at Orcust in action. So here is the deck. If Duel Links was load, here we go. Here is the deck, which, as you can see, the main focus, of course, is Bower Dragon. Because Bower Dragon is a dark, it triggers its summon off when dark machines are destroyed, which all of the Orcusts happen to be. So it works quite nicely. You then have things like Jinzo, because he's just very good against navigation. You know, the Dark Magician matchups, you play this guy out, you know, they're just like, nope, you can't play navigation, that's fine. And then we have World 1 to round up our heavy starter lineup. World 1 is only in here to be a target for Orchestrated Return, which we can discard, draw 2, and then use World 1's second effect to banish it, then special summon one of our banished Orcust monsters, which is any of our Orcusts, once they use their effects. And speaking of the Orcusts, we have 3 of them. Of course, we have Harp Horror, which can summon from the deck. We have Symbol Skeleton, which is summons from the graveyard. And we have Brass Bombard, the Tuner, which can summon from the hand. So all of these can combo really nice. You'll see in the dual replays after this, where we use Bombard to summon something out from the hand, and then we go into the Jinzo, and then we have the Bower Dragon on the field, and then we have like a Harp Horror on the field, and we just have a nice big board. We have a Jinzo, a Synchro, and a Bower Dragon. It's a very nice little engine for cycling through your deck and just reusing those graveyard resources quite nicely, getting things out on board to be tributed, and of course, destroyed to summon out your Bower Dragons. Now, the big things of Orcust is that after you summon them, you're locked into darks, basically. So that means locked into things like Red Dragon Archfiend or Samsara, but we're running things like Armades, Amatrix, Hastor, and Vermilion, just in case you do hard draw that Brass Bombard, or it's on a turn afterwards, and you can then go into a better level 5. Samsara right now is honestly really, really good for the current metagame, because when it's destroyed by battle or sent to the graveyard, you can target any monster in another player's graveyard and special summon it. So theoretically, you could then like revive your Desperado Bower Dragon, or if it's a Blue Eyes play, you revive a Blue Eyes or a Dark Magician or something to keep you alive for a few more turns. Samsara can do that. That's my favorite card to go to. We do need more, you know, dark dragons in the game that are level 5. That would be really helpful. So hopefully Konami do implement more cards to actually make this a more versatile thing. Of course, Orcusts aren't just, you know, restricted to being in this deck. They can be in tons of other engines. In the TCG, you have Lunalight Orcusts. You have a ton of other cool decks with them in. And as I said earlier, Black Salvo, when it comes to Duel Links, is going to be a good card for this deck to make the synchro plays happen a lot quicker, a lot easier, and might honestly take the deck, the Orcust engine, to being tierable. So yeah, I've had some cool success on the ladder with this. Maybe you guys will do too. Let me know what you think down below, and enjoy the replays. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next Duel Links video. See you then.
Yeah. Duel!